Hello everyone, I am Kabunesa Angasu from Jimma University School of Midwifery. I am a midwifery educationist. I do have midwifery background and specialty in midwifery education. So first of all, I would like to say welcome to this video teaching on introduction part of midwifery professional ethics course. This video teaching service not only students in Ethiopia, it also serves all midwifery students all over the world, since midwifery professional ethics is common for all midwifery students and midwifery professionals throughout the world. So I would like to say welcome to this video presentation, and also I would like to remind you that since now on I will prepare different video teaching on topics relevant to midwifery profession. Let you subscribe my YouTube channel in order to gain continuously all the video teaching I will prepare and upload on my YouTube channel. Specifically for new students who newly joined midwifery profession, I would like to say congratulations for joining this profession, which is very relevant and honorable profession through which you can appreciate and realize your true humanity. So in order to be effective midwifery professional throughout your professional life, all midwifery students need to be ready to sacrifice their life to their profession, because the care that midwifery professionals provide is in partnership with women and children. Naturally, our mothers are lovely, so they deserve to gain compassionate and respectful care. Also, providing compassionate and respectful care continuously may lead to compassionate fatigue, but even if provision of compassionate and respectful care may lead to compassionate fatigue, all the time midwives should have to be ready to cope up with the way how they can consistently provide compassionate care. So just to say this in terms of phrase, proverb, midwives should have lion's heart, ox's eye, and lady's hand throughout their life. Saying this, I would like to proceed to our today's presentation. So, as I have said before, the today's presentation is focused on the introduction part of midwifery professional ethics. Let us proceed by looking at the outlines of our presentation. So in this presentation, we will have session objective, brainstorming questions, some introductory part, history of midwifery profession, midwifery professional organizations, and also at last we do have some summary and references. When we come to the session objective, after the end of this session, all participants those follow this midwifery professional ethics video should have to be able to define what midwifery is, should have to also describe what midwife is, aligned with the definition set by International Confederation of Midwives. And also you are expected to describe, discuss the scope of midwifery practice, and then you are also expected to outline the four categories of essential competencies of midwifery practice outlined by ICM, International Confederation of Midwives. And also you are expected to narrate the history of midwifery profession on the globe and also specifically in Ethiopia. And you are also expected to discuss midwifery professional organizations internationally and also nationally in terms of Ethiopia. When you come to the brainstorming question part, let you think over what midwifery is, and also let you ask yourself, is midwifery profession important or not? The other thing, is midwifery new profession or old? The next is, what is the difference between the term midwife, midwives, and midwifery? Let you take a time and think over it, and it will be answered just within our next presentation. When we come to the definition of midwifery, midwifery is internationally recognized and a very relevant profession of midwives. Only midwives practice midwifery. So when we say midwifery, it is the name of the profession that midwives practice. And the professionals, the personals who do have midwifery profession are known as midwives. So the current midwifery students will be midwife after their graduation. Also, midwifery professionals collectively are called midwives. So midwifery has a unique body of knowledge, skill, and the professional attitude practiced by midwives within the professional framework of autonomy, partnership, ethics, and accountability. When you come to the international definition of midwife, midwife is a person, as I have already told you, midwife are professionals who practice midwifery. So there is a standardized definition settled for what midwife is. So this definition comprises three things. One, all about completing the educational program. The next is all about acquiring the necessary qualification to practice midwifery. And the third criteria is to demonstrate competency in midwifery practice. So let us see one by one. So midwife is a person who has successfully completed midwifery educational program that is based on International Confederation of Midwives Essential Competencies for Basic Midwifery Practice, and that is based on also the framework of International Confederation of Midwives Global Standards for Midwifery Education, and that midwifery educational program should have to gain recognition in the country where it is located. When you come to the second criteria, midwife is a person who has acquired the requisite qualification to be registered and or legally licensed to practice midwifery and use the title midwife. The third criteria is just midwife should have to demonstrate competency in the practice of midwifery. In general, midwife is educated, competent, and licensed professional to practice midwifery. So this definition is the international definition of midwives. So in different countries, especially in terms of Ethiopia, some people try to translate the profession midwifery into a wildlife nurse. That is very wrong. So it should be considered as illegal. So the profession midwifery is common name for all midwives all over the world. So all midwives should have to call themselves just by saying, "I am midwife." That is it. When we come to the scope of midwifery practice is the extent or the limit of interventions that midwife can perform. This means that there are scope of practice that is already standardized to be undertaken by midwifery professionals. So midwives should have to maintain their competency in order to appropriately and effectively undertake what is already outlined within their scope of practice. They shouldn't have to try to undertake what is beyond their scope of practice, and they shouldn't have to be fail to practice what is less than the standard already outlined for them. If they try to practice beyond their scope of practice, that is called a legal practice. If midwives fail to practice what they are expected to practice below its standard, that is called malpractice. So both of it is not accepted. So both of it is illegal. So midwives should have to know what their scope of practice is, and they should have to maintain their competency in order to effectively undertake their core competencies. So scope of midwifery practice outlines the essential competencies of midwifery practice that midwife is expected to undertake. Currently, there are four categories of essential competencies for midwifery practice as outlined by International Confederation of Midwives. So interested persons can search for International Confederation of Midwives 2018 update and can understand all the specification of the essential competencies for midwives and can stick their practice into what is already outlined as scope of practice for midwives internationally. In terms of our country, the current Ethiopian Bachelor of Science degree in midwifery curriculum outlined 12 essential competencies to be practiced by midwives in Ethiopia. That is derived from the four essential competencies category settled by International Confederation of Midwives. So we will see each of it one by one. When we see the four categories of essential competencies for midwifery practice that is outlined by International Confederation of Midwives, the first one is general competency. So the general competencies have a lot of specification under it, and these general competencies is expected to be practiced throughout professional, just midwifery professional activities by which they undertake all the rest three categories of competencies. Second competency is competency specific to pregnancy and antenatal care, and the third competency is competency specific to care during labor and birth. And the fourth categories of competency is competency specific to ongoing care of women and newborns. So the cumulative effect of every course midwifery student learn is to enable them to gain necessary knowledge, skill, and the professional attitude that enables them to undertake these categories of the essential competencies. So the first thing that midwifery students should have to do is that they should have to understand their scope of practice, their essential four competencies. After then, they should have to critically look at each and every course they take. So I mean, if all midwifery students understood what essential competencies they are expected to perform throughout their professional life, after then they will be just understand what is the relevance of learning each and every course they take through their educational program. So knowing their essential core competencies motivates all midwifery students to know the relevance of each and every course they learn. And they will know that the necessity of learning each and every course they are expected to learn is will be meaningful for them, and they will use it through their professional life. So they should have to be aware of each and every competencies that they are expected to undertake, and they should have to understand each specifications under each of it. So I would like to recommend all midwifery teachers to teach essential core competencies for midwifery practice by the time they give the first course. By now, the first course to be given for all midwifery students in Ethiopia is midwifery professional ethics. So even if core competencies for midwifery practice is not included with the course syllabus for midwifery professional ethics, I would personally recommend all midwifery teachers to teach the core competencies that midwives are expected to undertake. If you do that, your students will be motivated to achieve their essential core competencies. After then, they will give focus for each and every course they learn, knowing it's relevant. So I would like to recommend you to include these essential core competencies in your course content by the time you provide professional ethics course. So when we proceed to the core competencies for basic midwifery practice in the current Ethiopian curriculum, it is organized in 12 domains, and the first one is competency in social, epidemiologic, and the cultural context of midwifery practice. The second one is competency in family planning and pre-pregnancy midwifery care. The third one is midwifery care during pregnancy, which include antenatal care. The fourth domain of competency is midwifery care during labor and delivery, and the fifth one is competency during postpartum, competency to provide postpartum midwifery care. And the sixth one is midwifery care for newborns and under 5 children. The seventh is midwifery care for gynecologic patients. The eighth one is competency in organizational management and leadership. The ninth is competency in research and evidence-based midwifery practice. The tenth is competency in interpersonal relationship and communication. 11th one is all about competency in professional, ethical, and legal midwifery practices. And the last one is competency in basic midwifery care. So this is already outlined in the modularly harmonized generic Bachelor of Science degree midwifery curriculum of Ethiopia in the new one that is published on May 2021. So each midwifery student should have to ask their teachers to gain the description of all these core competencies identified by their curriculum. They should have to take it, they should have to read it, they should have to understand it, then they should have to prepare themselves the way by which they can able to achieve all these essential competencies. After that, they will focus on the relevance of learning whatever the course they learn through their professional process. I mean educational process. So when we proceed to the general description of what scope of midwifery practice is. So, in general, the scope of midwifery practice is built upon the International Confederation of Midwives internal definition for midwife, which recognizes midwives as a responsible and accountable professional who works in partnership with women. For what purpose? To give the necessary support, care, and advice before and during pregnancy, during labor and postpartum period, to conduct the births on the midwife's own responsibility, and to provide care for newborn and unified child in general. So, when we see the care that midwives can provide, midwives are expected to provide holistic care, starting from disease preventive measures and just care focused on promotion of normal health, normal births, and detection of complications in mothers and children, and provision of medical care or other appropriate assistance, and giving emergency measures. So, midwives are expected to provide holistic care. So, a midwife can practice in any setting, including at home, community, at hospital, in clinics, in health units, and in different managerial positions related to health. So, focusing on a care that midwives provide in any healthcare setting, what are the cares that midwives can provide specifically? Just midwives can provide neonatal and under five children's care. Midwives are appropriate persons to give sexual and reproductive health care, including family planning and preconception care. The other thing, midwives are the appropriate person to care for women during pregnancy, during labor, during delivery, and during postnatal period. The other thing, midwives are the appropriate primary persons to provide basic gynecology cares. So, midwife can assume different roles, including the following when we generally talk about it. So, midwives can provide midwifery care, they can be leader, they can act as change agent, they can be manager, they can be educator, they can be counselor, they can be researcher, they can be women's advocate. They should have to be the sound for women. So, they are also effective communicator, since all the care that healthcare providers provide, including midwifery, is concerned with talking with the patients or the caretakers, they should have to be effective communicator in order to able to identify what problem the patients have. If they are not effective communicator, they fail to build rapport with their patient, they fail to build trust between their patients and clients. After then, they will not understand what the real problem of the patient, because if the patient does not trust them, the patient will fear them and will not tell each and every problem they do have. So they are expected to be effective communicator. So when we proceed to the history of midwifery profession, midwifery is among the oldest profession on earth. Starting from the human existence on this earth, there were midwives, even if those midwives hadn't been trained on midwifery care, they have been practicing it in traditional manner. So when we consider those people's midwife is among the oldest profession on earth. When we consider evidence on biblical scripture on the Exodus chapter 1, number 15 up to 20, it stated that the existence of midwifery profession very far before Christ's birth. So the then mentioned midwives were Shifra and Pau. So midwifery profession has passed through varying stages in different countries. So previously midwifery was not that much linked with formal education. In most countries, modern midwifery education started in 20th century. When we come to history of midwifery profession, specifically to in Ethiopian context, the historical background of midwifery profession in Ethiopia is not well documented. But in the year 1950s, community nurses without having formal midwifery training managed births at basic health facilities in Ethiopia. The first formal midwifery training began in Asmara Nursing School as nursing specialty training for nurses before extra separation as a dependent country. So when we come to the current Ethiopian context, formal midwifery training began in Gondar Public Health College in the year 1953-1954. In terms of Ethiopian calendar, the formal midwifery training was started in Gondar Public Health College in the year 1946 as Ethiopian calendar. So the Zen midwifery training was a training that was given as advanced diploma training for nurses who already had diploma nurse. Following this, midwifery school was opened at Princess High Hospital in Addis Ababa by Dr. Catherine and Dr. Hamlin in the year 1959, which means 5 years after Gondar Public Health College started giving midwifery training. So the number of graduates at the time was very small, and only 7 students managed to complete their courses. But the midwifery training at Princess Eye Hospital ceased operation in the year 1962. That means after teaching for only 3 years. Okay, following the cessation of midwifery training program at Princess Eye Hospital, the Gondar Public Health College also stopped just giving the midwifery training in the year 1964. That means after 10 years consecutive training of midwifery in Gondar Public Health College. As a result, community nurses continued to play a role of gap filling in the year 1960 and 1970. So community nurses remained at the forefront of maternal and child health care service, operating in a very difficult environment. So in Addis Ababa Midwifery School, Addis Ababa Midwifery School was opened again in the year 1986 with the support of Swedish International Development Agency. And then Addis Ababa Midwifery School allowed diploma nurses, just as it has been being practiced within Gondar Public Health College and also Prince High Hospital previously. Addis Ababa Midwifery School continued enrolling nurses who do have already diploma nurse from the year 1986 up to 1998 for 12 consecutive years to study accelerated midwifery program in 1 year program as post basic nursing skill. But it was in 1986 that Addis Ababa Midwifery School started offering direct entry into midwifery diploma program, replacing the previous post basic training for clinical nurses. Later, direct generic diploma midwifery training was established at Gondar Health and Hawassa Health Science Colleges. Overall, from the year 2012 to 2015, 4,500 diploma midwives trained midwifery for 1 year after 2 years of studying diploma nurses by the program called Accelerated Midwifery Program, just with the support from a United Nations Population Fund and the Swedish International Development Agency. When we consider the time by which midwifery training was started at first degree level, it was Gondar University, University of Gondar, in the year 2005-2006. Gregorian calendar, University of Gondar became the first institution to offer Bachelor of Science degree in midwifery. Then it was followed by Addis Ababa University in the year 2006-2007, and then Makala University followed. 2 years on, University of Gondar began offering a master's program in midwifery, and before 2 years, Gondar University started midwifery educational program at PhD level. As when we come to the context of Jimma University started providing Bachelor of Science degree in midwifery program in the year 2003 to in terms of Gregorian calendar, it was in the year 2010-11 Gregorian calendar. So, in addition to public universities of Ethiopia, in the year 2007, Hamli Midwifery College, as initiative of Hamli Fistula Hospital, was opened as part of strategy to prevent obstetric fistula in Burayu, and still now it is providing midwifery training at degree level. As the year rolled on, more and more colleges and universities began to give training on midwifery in both diploma and degree levels, and currently there are more than 60 midwifery training institutions in Ethiopia, while 31 of them are public universities in Ethiopia, and around 29 of them are private colleges and private universities. And currently, 6 universities are providing midwifery educational program at master's level in Ethiopia, and one institution is providing a midwifery educational program at PhD level, as we have seen, that is University of Gondar. So the number of midwifery professionals in Ethiopia is increasing from time to time. When we consider chronologically, in the year 1980, there were only 294 midwives in Ethiopia, but in the year 2008, there were 1,275 midwives in Ethiopia. Then after 6 years, the number of midwives increased to 7,200 in the year 2014. So the ratio of midwifery professionals to population by 2014 was 1 midwife to 10,500 population, including children, women, other peoples. But this is less than half far away when compared with WHO recommendation. When I say WHO, it is World Health Organization. So WHO recommends a ratio of 1 midwife for a population of 5,000. So just we have seen the increment of or the expanding of midwifery educational program in Ethiopia, and also the increment of midwifery number of midwifery professionals in Ethiopia. What is the rationale behind? The rationale is that in effort to achieve Millennium Development Goals, that mean before the year 2015, the reason for expanding midwifery educational program in Ethiopia is that just to achieve Millennium Development Goal 4, which says to reduce child mortality, and Millennium Development Goal 5, to reduce maternal mortality. So as a main strategy, training midwives was taken as a key. That's why midwifery educational program has been expanded in Ethiopia. After the year 2015, this scenario continued. So internationally, the plan called Sustainable Development Goal came, especially the Sustainable Development Goal 3 talks about health, and specifically when we consider the reduction of maternal mortality, the plan is to reduce maternal mortality to less than 70 per 100,000 live births. Currently in Ethiopia, according to the data obtained in the year 2016, maternal mortality is very high. Comparatively, it is 412. So, to reduce it to less than 70 in the coming 2030, currently the Federal Minister of Health of Ethiopia has given greater emphasis on improving maternal and newborn health. So, the highest maternal and neonatal mortality occurs during labor delivery and the first 24 hours after delivery. So, as a strategy, our government gave greater emphasis on expanding educational training for midwives. In addition to the rationale we have seen, in the year 2006, World Health Report identified Ethiopia as one of the 57 countries having very severe shortage of midwives, medical doctors, and anesthesiologists. So, since our country do have very severe shortage beyond these professionals, including midwifery, the greater emphasis for expanding midwifery professionals was taken as strategy. That is why. So, midwives are front health workforce to monitor and provide basic care to women during pregnancy, labor, childbirth, and postnatal period, including care for neonate and under 5 years children. When we come to the last portion of our today's lesson, it is all about midwifery professional organizations. As I have told you on the introductory part, we will see two midwifery professional organizations nationally and internationally. In different countries do have their own midwifery association. So when we consider the history of International Confederation of Midwives, 100 years before, around 1,000 midwives have been having Congress especially in Germany, but in the year between 1900 up to 1954, since there had been conflict in the country, especially in European continent, I mean midwifery, international midwifery congress not that much effective. But in the year 1954, the name International Confederation of Midwives was decided for the first time, and it was held in London. At the time, a regular triennial congress was established and successfully continued. But in the year 1999, the International Confederation of Midwives Council decided to move the location of headquarters from their office in London to Hague. So currently, the headquarters of International Confederation of Midwives is in Hague of Netherlands. So what is the vision of International Confederation of Midwives? Its vision was to ensure every childbearing woman to have access to the midwife's care for themselves and for their newborn. Their mission is to strengthen and to advance professional midwifery professions globally by promoting autonomous midwives as the most appropriate caregivers for childbearing women and keeping births normal in order to enhance the reproductive health of women and the health of their newborn and their families. When you come to Ethiopian Midwifery Association, it is comparatively new. Its formation is in very recent years. So the Ethiopian Midwives Association is a national non-profit professional association that represents a work to strengthen midwifery profession in Ethiopia. So formally, Ethiopian Midwifery Association was established in 1992 and registered by Ethiopian Ministry of Justice in 1993, and it became the member of International Confederation of Midwives in the same year. What is its vision? Midwifery, Ethiopian Midwifery Association envisions midwifery to be valued and autonomous profession where every families have access to equitable and high quality midwifery services. Its mission is to strive for autonomy and excellence of midwifery care practice to provide quality care for women, newborn children, adolescents, and youth through strengthening self-reliance and influencing for change. Its goal is to contribute for reduction in maternal and newborn mortality and mortality in Ethiopia, newborn morbidity and mortality in Ethiopia, serious strengthening midwifery lead continuum of care. When you come to the summary, under this presentation, we do have seen what midwifery is. We have described midwife in terms of its international definition. We have seen the scope of midwifery practice, and we have seen the four categories of essential competencies for midwifery practice. We have narrated the history of midwifery profession, and we have seen the midwifery professional organizations. So just you can revise it and you can understand it more, and you can for further understanding you can use these references that I have used for my today's presentation. So at last, I would like to say thank you very much for your attention. Never forget to subscribe my YouTube channel. I will prepare a lot of relevant teaching videos. But never forget to subscribe my YouTube channel. Thank you for now. I love you so much. Thanks a lot.